Welcome again. Right now we're at Acts chapter 20, verses 1 through 7. And we're going to be talking about how Paul celebrated or observed the Passover. After the uproar had ceased, now remember we just got back from Acts chapter 19 where Paul caused no small stir in Ephesus. Paul sent for the disciples, took leave of them, and departed to go into Macedonia. When he had gone through those parts and had encouraged them with many words, he came into Greece. When he had spent 3 months there, and a plot was made against him by the Jews as he was about to set sail for Syria, he determined to return through Macedonia. These accompanied him as far as Asia, Sopater of Berea, Aristarchus and Secundus of the Thessalonians, Gaius of Derbe, Timothy, Antichicus, and Trophimus of Asia. But these had gone ahead and were waiting for us at Troas. We sailed away from Philippi after the days of unleavened bread and came to them at Troas in 5 days, where we stayed 7 days. Now here is where I want you to pay attention here. The first half of verse 6. We sailed away from Philippi after the days of unleavened bread. The feast of unleavened bread here is basically, it is included with the feast of Passover, okay? It's an 8-day feast. The first day of the feast, you're not supposed to work. It's like Sabbath. And the last day of the feast, you're not supposed to work. So the first day you're not supposed to work, and the last day you're not supposed to work, it's supposed to be like Sabbath, okay? That is why Paul waited until after the feast of unleavened bread before he set sail. If you were to go to any observant and knowledgeable Jew today and tell him about a man who lived about 2,000 years ago who waited until after the feast of unleavened bread before he set sail, that Jew would immediately know what it's all about. He would know, of course you wait until after the feast because, you know, the last day of the feast especially is the day of rest. You're not supposed to do anything on that day. You're not supposed to work on that day at all. You're supposed to observe that day as a Sabbath. This here is yet another little glimpse into Paul's practice of observing the feasts. And as always, seek God with all your heart and you will find him. Call upon him and he will show you great and mighty things. Love you guys.